Listening Library presents A to Z Mysteries, The Runaway Racehorse by Ron Roy. Read for you by David Pittu. Chapter 1. Josh picked up a French fry, dipped it in ketchup, and drew his initials on his plate. When he ate the French fry, a glob of ketchup plopped onto his shirt.
Rats! This is my favorite t-shirt, Josh said.
Dink put down his book and grinned at his freckle-faced, red-headed friend.
Was your favorite shirt, he said.
Josh, Dink, and Ruth Rose were taking a train to Larchmont, New York, to visit their friend, Forrest Evans. Forrest and Dink's Uncle Warren had bought a racehorse together. The kids were invited to watch the horse, Whirlaway, run in a race in Saratoga Springs. Josh picked up a napkin and wiped at the red stain. He only made it worse.
Josh is finger painting, Ruth Rose said to Dink. Someday I'll be a famous ketchup artist, Josh said.
He gazed out the window.
When do we get there? In a few minutes, Ruth Rose said, checking her train schedule. I can't wait to see Whirlaway, Dink said. I've never met a real racehorse before. All I can think about is horses. That's why I'm reading this.
He held up his book. It was The Black Stallion by Walter Farley. The cover showed a beautiful black horse with wild eyes and a flowing mane. Dink Duncan's real first name was Donald, and his middle name was David. But when he first started to talk and tried to say Donald David Duncan, it came out as Dink. Dink had been his nickname ever since.
Look what I brought,
Ruth Rose said, pulling a book from her backpack. The cover showed a girl on a horse. The book's title was Learning to Ride.
Josh, did you bring a horse book? Dink asked.
Josh grinned.
Nope. I figured you guys will tell me anything I need to know.
He dropped a few sugar cubes into his backpack.
Still hungry? Dink teased. They're for Whirlaway, Josh said.
Just then, the conductor walked through the dining car. Larchmont is next, he told the kids.
Oh, wait,
Ruth Rose said, digging in her backpack. She brought out her new camera. Ruth Rose liked to dress all in one color. Today, everything was white, from her headband down to her sneakers. Even her camera was white.
Would you please take our picture?
She asked the conductor. My pleasure, said the man. He took the camera and focused it on the kids. Say cheese.
Cheese,
they all said. The conductor handed Ruth Rose her camera. Have a great day, he said. The train slowed, then stopped. Dink, Josh, and Ruth Rose grabbed their backpacks and walked to the end of the car. The conductor lowered a set of stairs, and the kids climbed down to the platform. Dink heard someone call his name. He saw his Uncle Warren and Forrest Evans walking toward them. Dink's uncle was short and round and wore glasses. Forrest Evans had a trimmed brown beard and wore jeans and a t-shirt.
Why, it's Wink, Gosh, and Tooth Toes, Forrest said.
The kids had met Forrest when his painting had gotten stolen from Uncle Warren's apartment.
Hi, Mr. Evans, they all said.
Please call me Forrest, okay?
He asked. Dink hugged his uncle.
How was the train ride? Uncle Warren asked. Great, Josh said. The hamburgers were awesome.
Forrest led them to a black car and opened a rear door. The kids piled in with their backpacks. Uncle Warren sat next to Forrest up front. Forrest started the car and pulled out of the parking lot.
How many horses do you have?
Josh asked.
Just Whirlaway, Forrest said.
Do you ride him in races?
Ruth Rose asked.
Forrest laughed. No, I'm too heavy. Professional jockeys are small and light. I hired a woman named Sunny to be Whirlaway's jockey.
Awesome,
Josh said.
I've never met a girl jockey before.
Then he added,
I've never met a boy jockey either.
Forrest slowed down near a group of small shops and flipped on his turn signal. Dink, Josh, and Ruth Rose recognized the long, tree-lined driveway. They had been here once before with Dink's uncle. A minute later, Forrest stopped at his garage.
At the end of a stone path stood a large brick house. Out back, a stone barn nestled between a tennis court and a swimming pool.
"Here we are," Forrest said.
The kids climbed out of the back seat with their backpacks.
"When can we meet Whirlaway?"
Josh asked, looking toward the barn.
"Right now," Forrest said.
Uncle Warren headed to the house while the kids followed Forrest toward the barn. Josh dug in his pocket and pulled out a sugar cube.
"I brought this for Whirlaway," he said.
"That was a nice idea, Josh," Forrest said. "But Whirlaway doesn't like sugar. He's the only horse I've seen who doesn't."
Josh stuck the cube back in his pocket as the kids entered the cool, dim barn. Dink took a deep breath.
"It smells nice in here," he said.
"I agree," Forrest said. He also took a deep breath. "There's nothing like the sweet smell of hay and horse."
"Don't forget chocolate,"
Josh added. They all laughed as Forrest led the way to a stall near the barn's rear doors. The doors were open and sunlight poured in. Out back was a truck parked on a wide area of gravel. The stall door was also open, but there was no horse inside.
"That's funny," Forrest said, closing the stall door.
He thought for a moment, then smiled.
"I'll bet Sonny took Whirlaway out for exercise," he said. "They should be back soon. Let's go get you guys settled in the house."
He led Dink, Josh, and Ruth Rose back outside and into the house. They passed through a small room with boots on the floor and jackets hanging on pegs.
"This is the mud room," Forrest said, untying and kicking off his boots.
He took the kids through another door into the kitchen. The room was yellow with blue tiles on the counter and floor. Forrest pointed to a low bench.
"You can leave your backpacks there for now," he said.
The kids stood their packs on the bench. Dink glanced at a newspaper clipping stuck to the refrigerator door with a magnet. There was a picture of a dark horse with a diamond-shaped blaze on his forehead. The headline read, "Local Horse Beats All."
"Is that Whirlaway?"
Dink asked.
"That's him," Forrest said.
"He's real pretty,"
Ruth Rose said.
"He's even prettier in person," Forrest said, opening the fridge. "You kids like fruit?"
"We like everything,"
Josh said. Forrest set grapes and strawberries on the table. The kids sat down and began to snack. Suddenly, the door burst open. A small woman in jeans, riding boots, and a flannel shirt rushed into the kitchen.
"Hi, Sonny," Forrest said. "Say hello to Dink, Josh, and Ruth Rose. They're here to watch you and Whirlaway race tomorrow."
"He's gone,"
Sonny said, trying to catch her breath.
"Who's gone?"
"Whirlaway,"
she said.
"I just got here to take him out. When I looked in his stall, it was empty."
Chapter 2. Forrest looked up in surprise. Then suddenly, his face relaxed.
"Don't worry. I'll bet Whirlaway went to visit his mother again," Forrest said. "I'll call Mr. Bunks."
"Who's Mr. Bunks?"
Ruth Rose asked.
"Tinker Bunks owns the ranch next to my property," Forrest said. "He tried to raise horses for racing. He never had much luck, so he sold off his stock. That's how Warren and I got Whirlaway. Mr. Bunks kept Whirlaway's mother, a nice old mare named Biscuit."
"How does Whirlaway visit his mother?"
Dink asked. Sonny frowned.
"The rascal gets out of his stall and cuts through the woods," she said.
"I wonder when he got out this time," Forrest said. "He was here this morning when Warren got here. We went in and visited him."
"So he could have been gone all day,"
Sonny said. Forrest nodded slowly.
"Yes, it's possible, Sonny. But let's not worry. Last time he ran away, I found him safe and sound, munching hay with his mother."
Forrest reached for the phone and dialed. He listened, then hung up.
"Mr. Bunks's line is busy," he said.
He looked at the kids.
"If you're finished, why don't we jump in my truck and take a ride over there?"
"I'll throw down some fresh straw in Whirlaway's stall,"
Sonny said. She headed out the door toward the barn. Forrest put the fruit back in the fridge and the kids followed him out the kitchen door. He led them to the gravel parking area behind the barn.
Forrest's pickup truck was filled with bales of hay.
"Who wants to ride in the back with the hay?" Forrest asked.
"I do,"
Josh said.
"I will too," Ruth Rose said. "Otherwise, Josh will be scared."
"Just make sure you hang on."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.